The Harvestigator.
What kind of round is that?
44 mag. I don't know if I said that right.
Oh,
right.
Dude.
Can we redo that?
No, yeah.
Thank you.
What are we looking for?
24 volts. Okay, thank you. It should not be this difficult.
No, that thing's coming right off.
You want the to be attached to the boat. I'm a starboard. I don't know, if that's not fully charged, I don't know what is. Hate to leave them for a day, but sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do.
Oh, they're monsters.
Chungus chompus. Oh, they're eating. Look at them. We got lights. We got the harvesting device. Harpoon. This is to get the rounds out. We really need it. Most important part of this. We cannot leave without this. Whose name is that right there? I need you to sign this right now. They will give you a ticket if you don't sign this. We've got the tackle. Now we need the bait. We also need the rods. We need line. We're gonna get the outfitter for that. Stay tuned for that. This is the top secret lair. Try not to show the lair. You don't wanna scare the children.
This is my secret weapon.
These two are coming with us. I'm literally kidding.
Backpack.
Bait. Ancient technique of gator hunting with bait stems from the Japanese culture of fermenting fruit. I have been fermenting this beef lung 7th century. Here it is. Nice little chungus of goodness. That's beef lung for those that are vegans. We should have like a crispy count. Like how many crispies you drink in a day? There's nothing like putting your drinks, your crispies with your gator baits. Am I right? Count them off with us. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We got grandma's calling me. Let's see what grandma has to say. Hi, grandma.
Hi, Eric. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. What are you up to?
I'm going gator hunting. I am at the World Renowned New Smyrna Beach Outfitters of New Smyrna Beach. We're here to spool these things up because we want fresh line. Without fresh line, it's hard to be fine. Hi, Sarah. Hey, Sarah. I'm here to spool these two fine spinning reels. Cause I'm gonna do something extra special. It's always something special as well. Definitely good. Maybe it's this one. I think the spool's too big. I'm gonna get assistance on this because I don't. She's in the bathroom. It's a big spool.
It is a big spool.
Legendary. We're increasing velocity. Increasing velocity. Johnny's losing his damn mind. I'm at the outfitter. What does that even mean? Talk to us, Bobs.
I just had to, I couldn't leave without it. It's the Chuck Norris.
You're definitely gonna have to edit that because it's terrible. Dude, 0.5 makes me like kind of want to cream. We're here, live, hooked up, boat 95. We got all of the tackle we possibly could want to harvest an alligator. We're fueled up, wah-wah, stomach's fueled up, car's fueled up, boat's fueled up. Here we go, we're live. We're here at Lake Helen Blazes. We're at the boat ramp. A little nervous, seen a lot of airboats, Airboat Association.
Oh, this isn't looking good.
Okay, airboat trailer. Airboat trailer. That might be a real boat. Airboat Association. Private ramp, members only. Oh, whatever. We're going to find out the hard way. Okay.
How do you feel, Johnny?
I had 1 out of 10 chance of him being here. Negative 10.
We're here, boys. We're getting ready. We're getting the hooks on, the snag hooks. Gotta be careful with our legs. Gotta watch it. I've never been here. There could be a 12-footer right around here. We're gonna try the bait technique first. Gonna get the bait ready. Have two baits ready to deploy. See a gator, run past him, deploy the bait, set up as far as we can away from the gator, see if he pops up. He eats it, we wait for him to swallow it, then it's game on. Then it's getting another snag hook in. This is the forget-me stick. You get this thing in it, 100-pound test braid, giant treble hook, you got a lot of torque. Two trebles ready, two bait rods ready. Hopefully he only eats one bait, and then we tie a treble on the other one. We have three treble rods ready. They break treble hooks off. I've seen it happen before. They're big animals. Hope we're looking for one over 10. Never been here. If we see a 9-footer, we might end with a 9-footer. We're getting ready. Oops.
Backs out of the water. He's just chilling. We just went under.
The big one?
Yep.
Good.
Still got eyes on him.
We've got our first bogey.
He ain't going nowhere. That's his spot. Well, we're here. We're coming back to the boat ramp. Storm's brewing. Good one. Bobby found a good one. I'm calling it right. We just are getting away from the storm. A lot of lightning. We're going to use a tactical method that the native Ohachi Indians created to get this gator. We have to go to Walmart to get it first. Then we'll be back out there after the storm clears. And I have a really good feeling about this gator that's going to come back to the boat with us. Stay tuned.
Pit stop.
How to make a pit stop. Bass Pro Shop. Kite. We're going South Florida style. Never used a tiger's kite before. We'll see how this goes. It's gonna take a lot of adjusting. Come down, Clippy.
Here.
tight.
And no, we're not offshore.
With a kite.
There it is.
There's a gator out there about.
You see him up there, Johnny?
Oh, yeah.
Listen, we cannot lose this rod. We're approaching the gator. The outrigger clip on there. And we got the kite up there in the sky. I don't even know if I could see it. Okay. Just have it with the bail open right now. You ready?
Go for it.
Hold on. Just keep catching on it. Lift it out of the water. No, you want him to keep going. Just open it,
It's open.
I'm sorry. He swallowed it then.
Oh.
Swallowed it.
Tail is up out of the water.
I think he swallowed it, boys.
Tail
is up. He did the head thing.
Oh yeah, dude, I watched him.
He did it, 100%.
I watched him.
I just think that's crazy he would have done it that fast.
Well,
let's just chill. Let's let him digest it. I'm gonna bring the kite in.
Okay.
No way that.
What just happened?
Bobby, untie the boat.
He ate the bait.
And he swallowed. He did his little.
We were kite fishing with a sailfish kite. We fed what we think is a alligator with a bait hanging from a kite. Johnny's got the rod with the beef lung attached to it.
Dragon. This is his den. We've been stalking this gator for like 3.5 hours. It's not going to be an easy capture. Stop. Okay, I got it. This is going to suck. We got to go right through that. 44 mag. I don't know if I said that right.
Oh, dude.
Can we redo that?
No, yeah.
Please. Ready? 44 mag. Gator ender. This is going to be live. We're ready.
Gator ender.
This is safety. When this comes out, it's live.
Okay. Y'all just blew his hand off.
There's only three of us, so we can't off film. I just harpooned them. Got a good breath. Put the rod down down here.
Yep.
Flip it, reel it. Okay.
Ready?
He snagged. Dude, nice, really nice work. Nice job on snag.
Right here. Let go of it if you have to. Nothing. Oh, yeah. I need to drive through that.
Okay.
Johnny, you drive. Okay. You film.
Roger.
And we're going to switch when I...
Should I back up, get it directly straight?
This is like Blair Wiggins right here, except gator. This gator's right here, huh?
Alright.
The gator has the harpoon in him. Eric's gonna have to stick him again with the thing. We're following his life jacket around. There's gator on the end of it. I think he might be a little right. Oops, stop moving.
Don't move.
Okay, there he is. Let's see his bubbles.
But when he's drinking, lusting, and his hunger for power became known to more and more people, the demands to do something about this outrageous man became louder and louder.
Hopefully I did a good harpoon shot. Drive up to it, Johnny. I'm clear. Careful, careful. That's why the snags don't always work. There's an 11 footer on the end of that.
Yeah, that's a,
all right. That was a great harpoon shot.
I stuck him as good as I could.
I think you did. Good job driving.
I want to get two hooks then.
Yeah.
questions.